Hello, Internet! Did you ever wonder why I say the greenhouse effect is good for us? Well, because it is. Without the ability of our Earth to trap heat inside our atmosphere, this world would be totally different and a freezing cold wasteland. So the greenhouse effect is one of the major reasons why life as we know it is even possible. But, as always, we humans tend to overdo things. Let's first discuss what the greenhouse effect is and why it is so important. Every second, our Sun radiates large amounts of energy in a wide spectrum of different wavelengths into space and towards Earth. This energy, or light, is concentrated around a visible and near-visible spectrum. From short, high-energy wavelengths like UV light, to the long, low-energy waves like infrared or heat. All this energy is getting absorbed by the vegetation, the land, or our oceans, heating them up, and they begin to radiate heat in the form of infrared light. If our atmosphere wasn't able to stop this from happening, our planet would lose all the accumulated energy during the night, dropping the outside temperature far below zero. Not a place suitable for life. So to survive, we need some sort of trapping mechanism, which is the greenhouse effect. Let's now look at the composition of our atmosphere. The most abundant gases are nitrogen, oxygen, and argon. Those three make up around 99.9% of the air around us. That's without counting in the water vapor, because it is not uniform in our atmosphere. But even with the water vapor, it would still be around 99%. And none of these three gases even contribute to the greenhouse effect. They are just too stable to even care about infrared radiation. In other words, all that's keeping our planet cozy and warm are in the remaining 0.1%. The famous carbon dioxide, methane, ozone, nitrous oxide, and also the water vapor. All of them have something in common. They can, let's call it vibrate, and are able to absorb and re-emit infrared radiation, keeping the energy trapped inside our atmosphere. Again, the sun is shining onto the Earth's surface. Some of the radiation is filtered out by the atmosphere, be it absorbed or reflected, but mostly in the invisible spectrum, like UV or infrared. Aside from what the atmosphere is taking out, what's sending the sun's radiation directly back into space is anything white. Clouds or ice are perfect. So our ice caps also do their part to keep our planet at the right temperature. Everything else, land, sea or vegetation, absorbs the high energy radiation and again starts radiating heat in the form of long, low energy waves. But this time we have our superpower in place, the greenhouse effect. Instead of losing all the energy we gathered, the greenhouse gases absorb and reflect some of it back to Earth, keeping our planet at roughly the same temperature, year for year, day and night. And now, humans. Since the Industrial Revolution, we've been pumping tons of carbon dioxide and other chemicals into our atmosphere, changing the percentages of the different gases. I know the common question, are we really impacting this climate with so little on our big Earth? Well, look at it like this. Out of 1 million molecules of air, we always had around 275 of CO2, keeping our planet warm and stable. Since then, we increased the number to already over 400. An almost 50% increase, trapping more heat inside, thus increasing the global temperature. You see, even small numbers have extreme effects when the numbers are tiny to begin with. If we trap more heat inside, it gets warmer. Simple as that. Okay, then when should we start worrying about it? To be honest, decades ago. Right now, we are already at a point of no return. The ice caps are melting, revealing more land and sea that can absorb energy instead of sending it back into space the way ice does, and speeding up the process. What's more, the permafrost and methane hydrate on the seafloor are melting, releasing trapped methane and CO2 deposits into our atmosphere. All by itself, thanks to our industrial jumpstart. All we can do now is damage reduction instead of prevention. But this is at least something we can do. And if someone thinks their job and money are more important, then they are really in luck. They will have to work more jobs to pay for more frequent storm damage and increasing prices of everyday goods because of droughts, storms and global crises. And with that being said, thanks for watching another depressing episode. Have a good one.